We're good.
All right, Manny. You look good, you feel good, you feel good, you play good. Your style has already opened a lot of eyes. I know it's one of the things I enjoy watching, alongside you doing what you do on the field. You recently got a pair of shoes done by the shoe surgeon. Tell us a little bit about these, man.
So this year, Jordan Brand, we did the 13s this year. So it was one of my first shoes I ever bought when I first signed. That was the first shoe I wanted again. It was the same exact shoe. When I finally got to meet him, I kind of just had a conversation with him. He kind of just picked my brain on things that I liked, and I'm really big on the Python leather. I kind of just love Python. It kind of makes the shoe pop.
Yeah. And
so I told him, to do something like that, and he came up with this, and it's been, it's ridiculous how beautiful this
is. First of all, they're super light. But tell us a little backstory about this, because I've heard that you asked if you could slide in these things, and you were told no, and then what happened?
So I told him, he's like, are you going to wear them tonight? I was like, yeah, of course I'm going to wear them, but I'm kind of scared if I got to hit a double and I got to slide into second base, what's going to happen to this Python? I don't want to get this dirty.
Right.
He's like, well, don't slide, just hit out the ballpark. And I was like, okay,
That's a good idea.
Got a good point. Got a good point on that. And so it happens to be, I go out there and I hit 2 homers that night. So, I think that was a trick. Don't slide, just hit over the ballpark.
My goodness, is he hot. Number 22 for Manny Machado. Watch it fly. Second of the night for Manny Machado.
Now, you're one of 11 guys who are with the Jordan brand. Now, I know a couple guys who've been on Jordan, and all those guys had to wait a little bit of time before the man himself allowed them on. What was your process like being one of those 11?
Yeah, it was a long time. I mean, season got over with. They contacted me. I told my agent,
I want to do
it. Get me on. I want to do it. whatever you got to do, get it done. It took about 7 months, 8 months to get an answer back, just because obviously MJ is a busy man, and everything always has to go through him. He has to give the final approval on things. So, to be I was the number 7th guy on it. So it was kind of pretty special at that time. I was the first one that kind of opened up the gates to, get Mookie Betts, Butler, everyone else that came back. Because back then it was just, you had to be
a guy.
You had to be a guy. CC
Jeter. CC was one of the two, right.
You had David Price, Carl Crawford, Jim Rawlings. Gio was the last guy before me that got on it, so it was pretty. It was hand selected.
And so you kind of led the new era of the Jordan guys, especially from the baseball side, right?
Yep. I was the first one after him. Gio kind of started off a little bit, and I think they waited 2 years before they got me.
You know what was funny? When Gio first mentioned, I was like, "You lying? You went and bought those shoes, man? You ain't part of Jordan." And I found out he actually is part of Jordan.
A lot of people were saying that, but nah, man, you can't. What we get here is special. I mean, they take care of their guys, and they take care of the family. And
what is the process like? Do you guys get to pick whatever Jordan you want, and they just throw some cleats on?
I wish. I'll be getting some of these fresh ones. No, I mean, every year, I think we kind of keep it as a family. So, every year, they pick a shoe that we're going to use that year. So, I've used the 6s, 7s, used the 9s, the 4s, and then this year's the 13s.
Aside from the Python joints, which ones of the Jordan brand that you've been a part of it have been your favorite thus far?
I want to say the ones I did last year, the 9s were pretty special. I got, because it was the first year that they kind of let us expand and
because they were pretty tight when you first tie on.
They were real tight. It was generic colors, because MLB was very tight on rules too. But last year MLB kind of opened it up, and we're able to expand on kind of put our taste into things. So, I did the dolphin colorways last year with the teal and orange. So it was kind of cool that you could
mix it up
and put whatever you want on it.
Now, we talked about it a little bit off camera, both shoe guys. I mean, growing up, obviously Jordan was at the forefront. What was your favorite Jordan growing up?
The Bred 4s were number 1. I mean, that was when they came out. I was at an age that I kind of understand it. So,
going on,
I think that was the first big time I was like, oh, that's the shoe. that I always wanted. So I think I gotta say those were probably my number ones.
The patent leather ones for me, when they first came out, when this was, I think this was the first year Jordan had a full season after his retirement. I thought I was like,
You can wear it with everything.
You can wear it with everything. Well, listen, man, please keep up the fantastic work on the field. You've been awesome all year. But more importantly for me, I like watching the shoes, dog. So continued success, and I look forward to the creativity you're going to bring to the table.
Oh, so it's going to keep coming. I got some new colors coming next year, too.
We got the uniforms next year,
so it's gonna be.
Dude, you still break out the gold ones though from time to time.
Yeah,
you know,
I was out there. You got a gold patch on the side. So I gotta,
you found a way to sneak them in.
All right.